Today, the government announced its surplus, $8.7 billion, a government that's taken around about $35 billion in surpluses in the last 4 years alone. So New Zealanders, rightfully so, are feeling angry and frustrated that while they're struggling to make ends meet, paying increased rates, increased interest rates, increased energy and electricity prices, the government just hoards cash. Why? Well, Helen Clark told us the reason just a few weeks ago. She's building up a kitty. What that means, it's a war chest to try and buy an election in 2008, and what a lolly scramble under Labor it's going to be. It is a bit sad, I think, for New Zealanders that the only time they can expect a tax cut under a Labor government is election year, that for 9 years they've been seeing their wages rise much more slowly here in New Zealand than in Australia, because Australia's embarked on a tax-cutting program and New Zealand hasn't. So I think New Zealanders will be deeply cynical when they finally see the tax cuts. Michael Cullen this week announcing his 4 tests that had to be met before a tax cut was possible. New Zealanders will be able to put those alongside about the 10 or 15 excuses we've heard from Michael Cullen over the last 8 years. And frankly, I don't think they'll really wash when they remember that Michael Cullen was the man who in 2005, miraculously another election year, he did actually dish up a tax cut, only to take it off them before it finally hit their paycheck in 2007. So it's been an interesting week for the government. I'm leaving for London for a series of meetings I've got over there next week. Good opportunity to meet up with David Cameron, the Tory party leader, who had an outstanding conference and got an 8-point jump in the polls on the back of a tremendous speech from David and some strong promises around cutting taxes in the United Kingdom. It is always a great opportunity when you're overseas to reflect on the relationship that New Zealand has with one of our traditional allies, the United Kingdom, and to meet and some new acquaintances and contacts, and also get some new ideas of things that we can bring back to New Zealand. I won't be there at a time while the All Blacks are there, because, as we all know, they unfortunately failed to make it through to the semi-final. It was a pretty tough day for the All Blacks, and a great shame for New Zealand. We put a lot of store in our All Blacks, we expect a lot of them, and tragically in this case, they won't be bringing home the World Cup. But for me, it'll be a good opportunity to spend some time, to make some new acquaintances, and to build on some of the relationships I've already formed.